Hello and welcome, my dear students. How are you all? I hope you all are good. You all are doing best in the exams, in all the papers of FA2 exam. My dear students, now in the previous lecture, we have written few objectives of chapter number 6. And many students have even sent me the photos of the chapter of the objectives of whatever they have completed in their fair notebook. I am looking forward for few more photos, the fair book photos from your side. I hope that I will get the photos so that I'll be able to note down your name in the regular students and fair book complete list, so that you will be considered when I'll give the certificates once again in the online classes. My dear students, I hope that each and every instruction given in the online class is followed by you. Moreover, I hope that you are keeping up all the lectures, you are following up instructions given in the lecture. So, today also we are going to complete the objective part, remaining objective part of chapter number 6. I hope you all are ready with your fair notebook, and I hope that you will write with me. And one instruction I give you daily while the lecture is going on, that maybe you will not be able to complete the writing part with me. Sometimes it will happen, not all the time. I know you all are clever, smart, so you will be able to complete. But sometimes it happens that you will not be able to complete the full question or the answer written. So in that case, I always ask you to watch the lecture again and again so that you can complete your work. So let's get started with today's lecture. I hope you all are ready with the fair book. Give the heading, chapter number 6. Those who are writing in the rough book, those who are writing in the rough book, give the heading, chapter number 6. And those who are writing in the fair book, give today's date and wait for me to write the topic. I hope, my dear students, you are prepared with your fair book. And I hope that you are writing each and everything instructed in class. So, now I am going to write the heading, what we are going to start. So, today's first heading is give two example answers. So you can just give the heading two example answers. So I'll give the heading here two example answers. And I hope you will also give the heading with me. Okay, my dear students, I hope you have also given the heading two example answers, lesson number 6. Please give the heading and make sure that you try to finish writing the questions with me, so that you will not have to wait for the extra time. Although I am reading the questions, I am giving you few more seconds. So I hope that in that much time you are trying to at least complete the work. So, now what we are going to do, as always, I will write the question and then the answers. So, in the same way, today also first I will write the questions of two example answers. I will wait for a few seconds and then again we will write the answer. So, let's get started. Let us write the questions of two example answers. So, question number one is, things needed by living things to survive. Things needed by living things to survive. An answer we will write here. Number two, things that living things do. Things that living things do. Again, answer we will write in the next line always. Number three, breathing organs in animals. Breathing organs in animals. Again, space for the answer. Then number four, sense organs. Again, answer here. So, students, there are two example answers, not four, five. As you can see, I don't have space anymore to write the question and answer. As soon as we will finish all these four, again I will write fifth question here. Now I am waiting for you to complete all these four questions and then we will write the answer together. So please make sure that you complete these questions as soon as possible. Four questions, as you can see, I have written on the board. Number one is things needed by living things to stay alive or to survive. Number two is things that living things do. Number three is breathing organs in animals. And number four is sense organs. So I hope you are writing the questions. And as you can see that I have written the questions properly. Now here you cannot see whether I have left the line or not, but you people have to keep one line space after each answer. Let me explain you on the board. For example, if you are writing question 1, then in the next line write answer, and then you have to leave one line before writing second question. I'll wait for few more seconds. Please complete writing the questions. I hope, my dear students, you are completing it. Things needed by living things to survive. Things that living things do. Breathing organs in animals. And the last question is sense organs. You have to give two examples for all these questions. Yes, like I said, number 5 is left, which we will complete after writing all these four answers. So now I hope you are ready for writing the answers. So let's start writing the answers. Question number 1 is things needed by living things to survive. Now we are the living things. We are human beings. You and me, we both are the living things. So what do we need? What do we need? We need oxygen, we need water, we need shelter, we need food. So many things are there. So these four things are basic necessity of human beings. Food, shelter, water. So these are the basic necessities. Clothes. So any two you have to write. Any two things which we need to survive. So according to me, two main things are without which we will die. So two main things are as you can see, I have written the answer, air and water. This is what I feel. Without clothes, you will not die. It is necessary to wear the clothes and to maintain ourselves like a human being. But without water and air, that is without oxygen and without water, we will die. So these two I think is very, very necessary. That is why I have written. You can even write food, clothes, shelter, any two you can write of your choice. Now, number two is things that living things do. What do we do? Things that living things do. Many things we have done, many things we do, right? There are many activities we do. So, two main activities are grow, eat. These two, what I think is very basic and which you will be able to remember very easily. We grow in height, that means physically also, in age wise also we grow. So our age also grow and we eat. What do? We eat to get ourselves rejuvenated, energized. So grow and eat is the answer for number two. And I hope you all are writing it. Number three is breathing organs in animals. Breathing organs in animals. Now, by explaining you the lesson, I have explained you various breathing organs. We human beings breathe from the nose. Similarly, many animals also have the nose. Like I have already explained you that many animals have the same sensory organs as we human beings have. So which are the two breathing organs like we human beings have nose? So the answer for here is nose and air holes. Like I said, many animals also have nose like we human beings have. So nose I have written. Second, air holes. Many animals do not have nose. They have air holes on the body, on their body to breathe in. So nose and air holes is the answer for number three. Number four, sense organs. How many sense organs do we have? We have tongue to taste. We have ears to hear. Then we have nose to smell, eyes to see, and skin to feel. So these five sense organs we have. You can write any two because here you have to write two example answers only. So let us write the answer. Eyes and nose. Now I will wait for you to complete writing the answer. Please note down all the answers. I have written all the answers and I have underlined it. So students, please make sure that while you are writing the answer in the fair book, you have to also underline it properly with the pencil. Even if you write both the example on the different lines or on the same lines, you have to put the comma in between. As I have put the comma in between the answer to show that these two are the different examples. I hope you are following the same method as I am writing on the board. Air and water is answer 1. Grow and eat is answer 2. Nose and air holes answer 3. Eyes and nose answer 4. These answers can be changed if you want according to your perception. If you want to write any other examples, you can write it down. Okay, my dear students, now I am going to erase number 1 and number 2 so that I will be able to write number 5, question number 5, which is left for 2 example answers. You people have to continue in the same page. So, now I am going to write number 5, question number 5. after erasing these two questions. Till then you keep completing the work. If you have left, writing the answer for these 3 and 4. Question number 5. Question number 5 is animals that lays eggs. Animals that lays eggs. An answer will be written here. Please write the question number 5 as soon as you finish writing these 3 and 4. I hope, my dear students, you are writing question number 5. Number 5 question is animals that lays eggs. Which animal lay eggs? Okay. So I think now I should write the answer of number 5 question. Which animals lay eggs? So the answer I will write for number 5 is hen and pigeon. Hen and pigeon. See, even the snakes are there. So these are also, there are many animals who lay eggs. They do not give the birth directly to the young ones. They lay the eggs and then the young ones are hatched from the egg. So I have written hen and pigeon. You can even write snake and many more animals are there which you feel and which should be the correct answer, obviously. Animals that lay eggs, you can write any two name. Please write it down. I hope you are writing. So after finishing this, we are going to move towards one word answer. So be ready with the new page, new topic. We have to give new heading on the new page if you are writing in the fair book. Okay, now it's time for me to erase this content and to give another heading. You also be ready with the new page of your fair book. So, like I said, the new heading is give one word answer. So you also give the heading give one word answer on the new page. Okay, give one word answer. And students, you have always, I think that you have always observed that I always highlight the heading by double underlining it or in the different ways. You can see that while giving the heading, I have put asterisk mark to highlight it. So this way, whenever you give the heading, you have to highlight the heading in the header portion of the page. Now we are going to write the questions, obviously, as we do. So you have to write with me. Please start writing the question of give one word answer with me. So number 1, body parts that help birds to fly. An answer over here. Number 2, tiny holes found in leaves of plants through which they breathe. Answer we will write over here. Number 3, I hope students you have started writing the question. See, I have put comma here and I have written the half sentence number 1 here. As I was not having the space here, I have highlighted the heading. So that is why I have written the first half part here. Okay, number 3. Body parts of insect that help to feel changes around them. And again, space for the answer. Number 4, the process by which living things produce more of their own kind. Okay, so these are the 4 questions. I hope that you have also started writing all these 4 questions. So please make sure that you are writing the questions properly. Four questions are there. Number 1 is body parts that help birds to fly. Number 2 is tiny holes found in the leaves of the plants through which they breathe. Number 3 is body parts of insects that help to feel changes around them. And number 4 is the process by which living things produce more of their kind. All these 4 questions are there. Please write it down. So my dear students, I am going to read the question again. Number 1, body parts that help birds to fly. Number 2 is tiny holes found in the leaves of plants through which they breathe. Number 3 is body parts of insects that help to feel changes around them. Number 4 is the process by which living things produce more of their kind. Please finish writing the question so that we will be able to write the answer. And there are only 4 questions. Please complete it. So, if you will complete this, we will be able to write the answer of all these 4. And these are the last 4 questions for today's lecture. And most probably, in the next lecture, we will be doing question answers. So, I hope, my dear students, you are writing it. Okay, now it's time to write the answer. Number 1 is body parts that help the birds to fly. You know, birds fly like this. So, what is this called? What is this called? Hands? No. Then, with the help of what do they fly? Obviously, wings. Right? So, wings is the correct answer. Please write it down. W-I-N-G-S, wings is the correct answer, which helps the birds to fly in the air, in the sky. Number 2 is tiny holes found in the leaves of the plants, with the help of which they breathe. So plants breathe through the tiny holes called what? Obviously, it is called stomata. So please write the answer. Stomata. See the spelling and write the answer. Stomata. Number three is body parts of insects that help to feel the changes around them. So which body part of insects help them to feel the changes around them? If you have watched my video where I was explaining you the lesson, you must have seen the photo of one insect. There the antenna was there, right? So antenna is the answer. So please write the answer, antenna. And please make sure that spellings are right. A-N-T-E-N-N-A-E. Even I have the habit of checking the spellings two times. So you also should check it twice or thrice before you write in the fair notebook. Number four question is, the process by which living things produce more of their kind. Living things produce more of their kind. It is called reproduction. Reproduction. So please check the spellings and write the answers. I will keep the board clear for you so you can have the clear view of the answers. But please make sure that you do not make any spelling mistake while you are writing in the fair notebook. Check your spellings twice, especially for the answers, because in this exam I have seen that many of you know the answer. Because of the spelling mistake, we have to deduct your marks. So I hope, my dear students, you are writing the answers. Number one is wings. Number two is stomata. Number three is antenna. And number four is reproduction. Okay, my dear students. So I hope you have finished writing all these four answers. So with this, I end my today's lecture here. I hope you enjoyed writing all the objectives in the live class. So with this, I end my lecture, and in the next lecture, again, you have to be ready with your fair notebook or your rough notebook, because we are going to finish the question answer for this lesson. So hope you will finish that in your fair book. Wait for my other lecture. Till then, goodbye. Take care.